the Burndy Aluminum Insulation Piercing Compression Connector installation video. Topics we will discuss: product material overview, connector selection, tap wire stripping, die selection, die insertion, connector installation, cover installation. Chapter 1, Product Material Overview. Before we get started, be sure you have the following materials. Installation instructions. Prior to installation, installers are required to read and understand the installation instructions. Proper compression connector. Two plastic cover halves. One half with strain relief devices and the other half without strain relief. Proper Burndy crimp die set for the connector. See SOMI, sales drawing, or catalog page for proper die set selection. Proper Burndy installation tool identified in the installation instructions. Chapter 2, Proper Connector Selection. Proper connector selection is determined by the wire accommodates for the application, as this will determine the actual connector to be used. In this video, we will be installing a IPC 34H CWC connector. For this connector, the main run conductor accommodates a 500 kcmil aluminum compact stranded PV wire rated 2 kV and 90 degrees Celsius. The tap wire accommodates 10 AWG copper compact or concentric 7 or 19 stranded PV wire rated 2 kV and 90 degrees Celsius. Chapter 3, Proper Wire Stripping. The main run trunk wire does not require wire stripping, as the connector is designed with insulation pierce features. The tap wires require insulation stripping to ensure optimal electrical and mechanical performance. Proper wire strip length is identified in the installation instructions provided with the product and the sales drawing or master catalog. When stripping the insulation, be careful to avoid cutting or nicking wire strands, as damaged strands can affect the integrity of the connection, both from an electrical and mechanical standpoint. Chapter 4, Proper Die Selection. The P die sets are unique for this product line and designed for the 15-ton 46 series crimp tool platform. The P die selection will depend on the connector being installed. For the IPC 34H CWC, the required upper die will be the PIPC 34U, and the required lower die will be the PIPC 34L. P dies fit in Burndy's 15-ton 46 series crimp tools. Burndy recommends our T3 version, so installations can be tracked, traced, and transmitted for connection validation. Chapter 5, Proper Die Insertion. For the lower die half, press the die pin release button on the side of the tool head. Slide the lower die into the tool head, aligning the die holes with the tool locking pins. Release the die pin button and wiggle the die to be sure it is properly seated. For the upper die, press the die pin release button at the top of the tool head. Slide the upper die into the tool head, aligning the die holes with the tool locking pins. Release the die pin button and wiggle the die to be sure it is properly seated. Once both die halves are properly seated in the tool head, you are ready for crimping. Chapter 6, Connector Installation. Before making a connection, verify that the tap wires have been properly stripped. Hold the stripped tap wires against the connector so the stripped insulation is butting the connector side. Visually verify the bare wire extends beyond the connector by a quarter inch, as this ensures that the wire will be fully inserted into the connector and has enough exposed wire to be bent upward, holding the tap wires in place during installation. Insert each tap wire fully into the connector. After inserting each wire into the connector, use a pair of pliers and bend the exposed wire ends up as much as 90 degrees, preventing the wires from slipping out of the connector during installation. Before installing the connector on the main run conductor, be sure the connector orientation is correct, as this orientation will dictate the cover orientation. As a recommendation, if you are installing the connector in an application with no parallel wiring or horizontal space constraints, orientation 1 is acceptable. If you are installing the connector in an application with parallel wiring and space constraints, orientation 2 is recommended. Orientation 1. If you seat the connector on the trunk conductor vertically, as shown, the cover width will be installed parallel to the ground. Orientation 2. If you seat the conductor on the trunk conductor horizontally as shown, the cover width will be installed perpendicular to the ground. For this demonstration, we will be installing the connector based on orientation 1. Seat the connector over the trunk conductor, resting the three piercing teeth on the conductor as shown. Seat the connector in the die set. Be sure the connector is pushed against the lower die backstop. Once the connector is properly seated in the dies, begin the tool's crimping cycle. Tool indicates a full cycle has been completed when an audible pop sound is heard. Due to the compressive forces in the dies from the connector, installers need to shift the tool head to the side, releasing the connector from the dies. Some tools also depict a green indicator light as a secondary indicator of a completed crimp. A red light would indicate an incomplete crimp. Chapter 7. Cover installation. When removing the plastic packaging from the covers, do not tear the packaging as some of the plastic could make contact with the gel. We want to avoid displacing or damage the gel seat. If any plastic comes into contact with the gel, peel the plastic away from the gel slowly and the gel will set back into place. Start with the cover half that has the locking handles and strain relief devices as shown. Open the locking handles and upper strain relief arms. Align the cover to the connection by main run wire will seat in the cover's main run alignment guides on each side. Align the connector so it seats inside the connector alignment guides. Bend the tap wires above the main run connector so they don't get in the gel while seating the connector in the cover. Slide the connector into the cover. Be sure the main run wire is in the alignment guides and firmly push the main run wire into the gel. If the tap wires are coming out one end only, lock the strain relief on the end with no tap wires. To do this, first close the upper strain relief on the wire and then close the handle on the upper strain relief. Press the handle into the upper strain relief until it locks into place. The cover will be secured to the wire, so you can let go and work on routing the tap wires into the other end of the cover. Seat each tap wire in the gel, making sure each wire is properly routed in the cover and strain relief wire alignment grooves. Close the upper strain relief on the wires and then close the handle on the upper strain relief. Press the handle into the upper strain relief until it locks into place. Take the other cover half, without the strain relief, and install. Align the cover orientation by aligning the post and holes with the other cover. Seat the cover on the other cover half by mating the alignment posts and holes and locking tabs. Firmly snap into place all 8 locking tabs on all 4 sides. Once all locking tabs are snapped into place and secure, your installation is complete. This concludes the insulation piercing compression connector installation video. For more information about insulation piercing compression connector product solutions, scan the QR code, visit the Burndy website, or contact customer service. Thank you for watching.